So today we're looking at one of the most challenging problems that I put on my last calculus exam. I asked the students to prove this identity. So you could call this a power reducing identity for an integral of sine to the nth power. So it turns out if you integrate sine to the nth power, where n is some integer greater than or equal to 2, then you can express this in terms of an integral of sine to the n minus 2 plus a leftover term here, sine to the n minus 1 x cosine x over n. Now in my class, we had previously seen proofs of a couple similar identities as we were reviewing past exams. So I figured it was a fair question, even if it was a hard question. So we need to start thinking about how we're going to get this right-hand side to occur. And the trick here is to use integration by parts. So I'm actually going to start by splitting off one factor of sine from this integrand. And just so this doesn't seem completely random, my motivation here is that I see over on the right-hand side that I have a sine n minus 1 term. And I'm thinking if I use integration by parts and just let this first piece be equal to u, and the second piece here be dv, I'm going to get something like that expression to pop out. So that's what kind of gave me my sense of direction to try this. So we're going to let u equal sine to the n minus first power of x. And that means du requires the chain rule here. So to get du, I have to differentiate with respect to the sine function. That gives me an n minus 1 sine to the n minus 2 of x times the derivative of sine x, which is cosine x. And there's dx on there. Now dv is the other piece. That's sine x dx. And that means v is going to be negative cosine x. So now when I apply integration by parts, I have to write down u times v. So that's going to be a negative cosine x times sine to the n minus first x. And this is really encouraging because I'm seeing the numerator of that second term in the identity that I'm trying to prove. We'll get to how the n ends up in the denominator eventually, but at least we have that numerator figured out. And then the second part of the integration by parts formula is that I have to subtract the integral of v du. Well, v carries a minus sign already, so I end up with a plus. And then when I multiply du by v, I end up with a cosine squared there. And then du carries this constant factor of n minus 1 that I can move out in front. And I have a sine to the n minus 2 x, and then I have a cosine squared x. Now this is also encouraging because I see a sine to the n minus 2 power. What I need to do to isolate an integral with a sine to the n minus 2 power is apply a trig identity to cosine squared x. And that's just 1 minus sine squared x. So now when I distribute inside this integrand, I end up with two different integrals here. One of them is the integral of sine to the n minus 2 of x. Again, that's really good news because we have that in our identity. And the other one gives me a sine to the n of x. And that's just because the exponents add here. If I take sine to the n minus 2 times sine squared, I get sine to the n. So I'm going to go ahead and split this up into two integrals now. This term out in front is still a spectator. So my first integral is going to be the integral of sine to the n minus 2 of x dx. And then my second integral, that comes with a minus sign. It's going to be minus an n minus 1 integral of sine to the nth of x dx. Now at this point, we have to complete the integration by parts looping trick. What's happened here is that on the left-hand side, we had the integral of sine to the n of x dx. Everything we're looking at here on the right-hand side is a result of just playing with that original integral. And what we notice is that we get a copy of the original integral on the right-hand side. So I'm just going to add that to both sides of the equation. And this means on the left side of the equation, I have my original integral sine to the n x dx plus an additional n minus 1 times the same integral. And on the right-hand side, what's left over here is an n minus 1. I'm just going to reverse the order of these two terms to start converging on the right-hand side of the identity we're trying to prove. So on the right-hand side, I have this term first. I have an n minus 1 times the integral of sine to the n minus 2x dx. And then I have this leftover piece minus sine to the n minus 1 x cosine x. So now on the left-hand side, I have an integral of sine to the n plus n minus 1 times an integral of sine to the n. Well, that's one of those integrals plus n minus 1 of those integrals. That's n of those integrals. So to isolate that integral, I divide both sides by n. So what that looks like on the right-hand side is an n minus 1 divided by n times the integral of sine to the n minus 2x dx, and then minus sine to the n minus 1 of x cosine x divided by n, and we've proven our power-reducing identity. Now, the reason people even bother to write this down is that it might be useful in a case where you're given, like, sine to the 8th power or something like that. You'd be able to knock it down in terms of an integral of sine to the 6th power. Then maybe you apply it again and get to sine to the 4th power, and so on. Now, I don't encourage my students to memorize formulas like this. If you're going to start memorizing formulas like this, there's just way too many to possibly keep them all in your head. It's the process, in my mind, that really matters here. So practicing these derivations can be really instructive. That was just great practice on the integration by parts looping trick. And I think this sort of thing just makes a wonderful challenge problem for calculus exams. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.